going to come right on. Good evening, and welcome again to What in the World. What in the World? Here's the mission statement. I'm going to read it for everyone. The World Affairs Council is an independent, nonprofit organization dedicated to informing and educating our community on worldwide issues. Now, we're back. And I'll say it again. Welcome again tonight to What in the World. We have a wonderful show for you tonight. We really do. It's going to be excellent. Have beautiful guests doing exciting things and ready to talk about things that they're engaged in at Penn State Berks in conjunction, really, with the World Affairs Council. So we're very lucky. And just before we get to them, I want to briefly mention upcoming things that are going to be happening with the World Affairs Council, because I know once we start with this, we will not have time to do that. Our next thing that is going to happen is going to be a breakfast, which is going to be at the Why Missing Family Restaurant. Dr. Noonan will be from Penn State will be speaking about challenges facing the European Union, which, as we all know, if we've watched any television, listened to anything, are amazing right now. And that is going to be at 7:30 in the morning on November the 4th. Please come. We have been having great turnouts for our breakfasts. They have been excellent, and we hope you will come and continue lifelong learning or early life learning, whatever suits you. And then on November 11th, we will have Dr. Donald Lee, and he will be speaking at our luncheon at the Inn at Reading, and he will be talking about the United Nations Millennium. So we know that that is another very important and interesting topic. So we hope that you'll join us at noon at the Inn at Reading for that. And now I'd like to get right to our guests. And maybe we can start at the far end. We'll start with you, Elizabeth Carney. You are a junior, is that correct?
That is correct.
At Penn State. All right. And we have Norrell Fry, and you're sophomore.
Yes.
All right. And Adriana
Yes.
Perez, right? Did I get it?
Yes.
Okay. Perfect. And you are a junior as well.
Yes.
All right. And they are our guests tonight. And they are going to be talking about something that people at the World Affairs Council are very excited about. They are going to be talking about the new World Affairs Club at Penn State, right?
Yes.
Okay. So let's turn to you, Elizabeth, and you tell us how this got started, if you can.
So this is really a work in progress, I think, over the past at least 10 months. And your former intern at the World Affairs Council, Jared Moser, he kind of got the ball rolling at our campus and got in conjunction with a former student who was there, as well as one of our alumni and Dr. Noonan. And between them and myself, we thought, wouldn't it be great if we had a club here that would be getting all of our global studies students involved? We have a number of international students, all of whom are invested in these world issues, and kind of creating this dynamic space where we could all discuss these together. So it was kind of at the end, I would say, of last semester that we had our first couple of meetings, got our funding as a club, and then this is our first official semester then really in action, digging in and getting things done. So it's been very exciting.
Wonderful. How many international students do you think you have in your club? And Is it primarily international?
I would not say it's primarily international, but I would say at least a quarter, perhaps, of our regulars are certainly mm-hmm. international, mm-hmm. and then the vast majority are probably global studies students or either international politics or some kind of either specialized cultural studies majors. But for the most part, yeah, I would say domestic, but we certainly attract a large number of international.
Okay. Oh. We're so excited about this at the board meetings. We're so delighted that they're with us. First of all, they've lowered our average age by about 100 years, which is really great. And it's just terrific. Okay, now, Adriana, you're going to tell us. I said this. I don't think I said it very well before the show came on. I said, how do you get people to come? That was not well said. How, I should have said, how have you encouraged people to join the club?
Okay.
Well, like Elizabeth said, our club is relatively new, so it's been a bit challenging to get people to come. But at the same time, I've been doing a lot of personal selling, and we've been doing a lot of personal selling in the club rushes at the beginning of the year. Like, there are different clubs in the campus. We have tables and we talk to students. So a lot of personal selling has been involved. And I have also done a lot of social media promotion. I take a lot of my flyers and I put it in Facebook, in the different club, in the different classes from the different, like Penn State 2017, 2018. And of course, Dr. Noonham, he has been the moderator of this club. He's our advisor and he has promoted it in his classes and just talking to different faculty and just sending emails. So I also focus on promoting the luncheons and the events that the War Affairs Council offers, and I think that's been what's been attracting most of the students, because there's such a great opportunities just to hear these different speakers talking about these important topics that we as primarily global studies and international affairs majors, we really like them. So that's been one of the main reasons why students come to our club, just to go to the luncheons and just be with another students that share those interests as well.
And what, now you said it's Friday. The club meets on Friday.
Friday.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Club Friday afternoon.
Friday at 1, yep.
And where do you meet?
It's a room in the Thun Library. It's Thun 135.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, well, that's wonderful. All right. Well, now, I know that you've gotten some things started, some projects and things like that, and I know that we want to talk about those because those are important, and we also want to hear from these three who are world travelers or about to become world travelers. So we're going to hear where they've been or where they're going. But now, Noelle, your turn. You're going to talk about breakfast and lunches. And getting people there, and whether you've liked them or not, we really like having them. The luncheons usually have a large Penn State table, mm-hmm. almost always. And you are applauded for. I know you've heard that from the older people who are there. We're so thrilled that they're there. They're a strong presence. But how do you get what?
Okay. Well, again, to back off of what Adriana said, Mr. Noonham plays a huge role in these. Like, he also sent emails out to everybody. But the breakfasts, the...
That's okay, we went through this. Is it breakfasts, everybody, or breakfast? We don't know. But anyway, you get it. It's breakfast, right?
The breakfasts and the lunches, like, it's one thing to talk about it amongst your peers, about what's going on globally and internationally, and it's one thing to hear it from a professor and then be quizzed on it or tested on it, but to hear it from someone actually involved, like, that plays a big part in, like, the conflict or the crisis somewhere. It's really huge, and also it's a nice opportunity to network with other people that are involved in the same thing you're involved in. Also, it's we have a table, like Penn State has a table, but there are also some high school kids too, so that's a good way to, like, maybe bring them to our school and tell them about our club here and maybe get involved with their global studies thing at their club too.
That's right. And Norrell is absolutely right, because we get Penn State always. Mm-hmm. Every once in a while we get one of the other colleges, but we always get a large number of high schools, mm-hmm. and they're usually Model UN, AP, mm-hmm. AP History, some of the students who are going to be on the WorldQuest teams, mm-hmm. they are the students that come, and they're high school kids. And if they see people from colleges and universities, mm-hmm. they're also, it is really great. So it's a very good model for them. I agree with you. Yep. Have you liked them? Have you liked it?
I've enjoyed them. I learned a lot from them. And I think what I enjoy the most about them is they're not reading, like, from notes.
They're talking about
their experience in the situation, what can be done to make it better, like, what's going on. Like, these are not people that have read a book and now they're trying to tell you about what's going on. Like, they know. Like, yeah. They've been there. They're in the forefront of what's happening. And other people know too, so it's like you learn more from who you're sitting next to and from the speaker.
Right.
And there's food.
So. And sometimes the questions are, and there's food. And it's pretty good food, isn't it? And that dessert table is to die for. Yeah. And I think also the question and answer things are very good because you're surprised at how good the questions are. Mm-hmm. And speaking of which, the Penn State World Affairs Club came to our breakfast where we had a gentleman from Alvernia speaking about Pope Francis, who was coming to Philadelphia that very weekend. And he did a marvelous job.
I mean, wonderful.
It was fantastic. He was fantastic. And the Penn State group asked some wonderful questions. And I applauded the questions because I thought, oh, because the more you ask, the more, I mean, he knew how to answer.
Oh, it's such an engaging topic. How can you not be interested?
How could you not be interested? Exactly right. Well, now, let's talk about this big project that's coming up. Okay?
All right.
All right. Who wants to take that away and tell us about that? Because that happens to be this Friday.
Am I right? It's this Friday,
okay,
yes.
This is their first big project, everybody. It's pretty good.
I'm sure we'll all contribute, but I'll kick it off here. So we're actually sponsoring what the CIEE terms a passport caravan. And the CIEE, for those who don't know, is an organization that basically, in a nutshell, they sponsor these global programs for students. And a bunch of universities, they'll plug into these and make use of those programs and have them available for their students. So around the country, they'll sponsor these events, and through them, 100 students actually get free passports. And it's all part of other initiatives that they do to promote study abroad and getting students to travel and kind of be more engaged in kind of this global and political landscapes. So our campus actually got selected. We wrote a proposal over the summer, and we were selected to host this event. So we're very excited. And our club, along with Dr. Noonham and some other global studies contributors, have been trying to make this happen, and it is this Friday. We're very, very excited. It's been the product of months of planning between our club, people here, and then also people at University Park constantly back and forth. So we're very, very excited.
Well, now tell us what will happen. How will this happen exactly?
This has been where the puzzle has kind of comes into play. It's been a lot of puzzle pieces.
I've asked a bad question. Stop me.
Yes. We have representatives from University Park who are coming down, along with actual government employees. So we're a little unsure what the specifics are. They're kind of taking care of really running that day and all of those logistics. But we will have students who will be going to different tables. They'll have to have, of course, all of their documentation. So birth certificate, social security number. We organized a photographer coming to campus who took all of the passport photos for these students. We had them printed on the spot, completely free for them, which was great. And so they should have all of these documents with them, and it should be pretty streamlined. They will have already made an appointment prior, and they'll have their check, which is sponsored by the CIEE, to pay for it. And they'll go over, the officials will go through all of their paperwork, and then they should get their passports within the next couple of weeks.
Oh, that's wonderful.
It is. It's fantastic, especially considering we have a large number of students who live on campus, so who may not otherwise have access to either getting a photo or getting their passport, because it takes a lot of back and forth.
It does. So. It is a very complicated process. I know that from having done it and been able to drive around and have a car and do stuff. It's really hard, and then you wait a long time. And,
absolutely. So this really streamlines it. Plus, it's expensive. So
expensive.
We joke, we're all in college, we're all broke. So it's nice to have some freebies.
Yeah. Everybody's broke, and you know. It's wonderful that you're doing that.
Yes, we're really excited.
That's great. So you three will be front and center, am I right? You'll all be there?
Absolutely.
Doing something.
We'll be there.
Running around, doing something. Getting them in organized lines, doing whatever you need to do. You'll be doing it.
Yep, and what's great is we're piggybacking on some other things, and we're actually sponsoring a study abroad promotional event, so we're going to have speakers from University Park speaking to students, and we've got some other events going on throughout the day to really get this information to students.
Oh, so, wonderful. So it's really like an international day.
It really is.
Oh, yes. That sounds great. Good. Well, I'm proud of you. That's wonderful.
Well, thank you.
And I want maybe you'll tell us. You said earlier when we were talking that you would like to have people who are speakers for us come and speak at your school. Tell us a little more about that. That's very interesting. Do one of you want to talk about that? I know you said it's hard for students to get away a lot of the time. Yes, go ahead, Niall. You're ready. You're ready.
Yeah. Well, it is very hard for like students to get away from the campus because it seems like anything interesting almost is here. So it's like we go to school here. A lot of us live here. At night, we want to do something off campus. Yeah. So I think our club is unique in a way that we are given the opportunity to the students to possibly go away to like to the lunches and the breakfast mm-hmm. to see the speakers, but it's even better to have them come here.
Yes.
And it's not something normal. Like, it's not, like, I don't know, they're not talking about anything urban. They're talking about things that will affect us today, tomorrow, and next week. Like, it's very important, and everyone should know about it, and we're bringing them here yeah. free of cost to the students. And I yeah. think that's just very...
Excellent.
It's nice.
It would be excellent if we could get more of them mm-hmm. over there, too.
Yes.
I understand your point exactly. Now, I know we've had our sign held up about time, and these three are very exciting because they're all either have traveled or are getting ready to go. So let's hear. Now, Adriana, you begin. Where were you this summer?
Okay. This summer, I spent 6 weeks in Buenos Aires, Argentina. And I was really excited to go there because when I was growing up in Puerto Rico, I would listen to a lot of rock bands from Argentina, and I'm a huge soccer fan, and I feel like Argentina is one of the best soccer teams in the world. So I was really excited to go there, and I had the opportunity to study abroad there, and I took two classes, one Spanish for business, and then the other one was international business with a focus in Latin America, so that was pretty exciting as well. But I also got to travel to a lot of places in the city. I went to the Casa Rosada, which is where the president of the country has her office. And I also went to different museums, and just getting to know the people in the city was just really an amazing experience. But I also got to travel to other places in Argentina. Like, I went to the northern part with the border with Brazil to see the Iguazu Falls. And then I also went to the west part of it to see the Mendoza, which is a province that is right in the border with Chile, and I had some wine tours there and some horseback riding as well. So I did a lot of things, and I even went out of the country because I went to Uruguay for a day. So it's pretty
exciting.
Exciting. It's such an experience.
Okay, now, Narelle, where are you going this summer? Let's hear.
I got the amazing opportunity to go and study abroad in Greece for next semester. And I'm so excited to go. I wasn't expecting to go so early because I'm only a sophomore, but I saw the opportunity at Greece and I just jumped on it, and I didn't even realize I was accepted. I had to call Elizabeth at night and ask her, like, am I accepted or not? And she was like, yeah, you are, congratulations. And I was like, yay! And it's hitting me now that this semester is coming to an end almost. Like, I'm going to be in Greece next semester.
Oh, and it's next semester.
Yeah.
It's not this summer. It's even earlier
semester.
Than that.
Yeah, so I'm really
that's
excited.
So wonderful.
For the history. That's my main part.
And she's going to travel. She's got plans. She's going to be everywhere. Right?
Yes.
Yes, you're going to go to the islands.
I'm
you're
so
gonna...
excited. It's so beautiful. I have the pictures of my screensaver on my planner, my iPod, my phone. Beautiful.
Oh, well, we're going to have to hear about this when you come back. And then if Elizabeth can get it, I know you're coughing.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. It's not your fault. Something in here got you. But I want you to tell our audience where you're going, because this is very interesting too. Right. Where are you going?
I will be going to Wellington, New Zealand, and I'll be studying at Victoria University there. I'm very, very excited. I can't wait. A little terrified, perhaps, because it is on the other side of the world. You know, so if something wrong happens, hopefully it will not, God willing. But if, you know, that is far away, distance. But
it'll be wonderful. Now, you said you're also going to do your research and your thesis there.
Yes.
Now, on what?
Yes, I'm hoping, and obviously not being there, I will be kind of adjusting to the landscape once I'm there. But my hope is that I will be able to research kind of the integration between various traditional political values of the Maori there and the integration of that with... excuse me, kind of this New Zealand of modernity. Yes. So these ideas and how they're trying to modernize their state, their political system, and New Zealand's done something that's quite remarkable in that they've really integrated amazingly well with the traditional Maori culture and that indigenous culture with kind of this Western, these Western influences. So I'm hoping while I'm there to kind of really delve into that and hopefully have my thesis feature that. So we'll see.
Are you planning to come to return to?
I will have to because I'd like to graduate.
You'd like to graduate.
I'll come back to finish my senior year
and then go back.
Yes. So.
Oh, that's wonderful.
I'm excited.
Now, are outsiders invited on Friday to come to this wonderful day? Is that possible for, say, people from our board or people who are interested to see this?
Okay. Of course, absolutely. All right. We'll have kind of students rotating throughout the day because we'll have class commitments. Some of us have work commitments, so we may not be there the full day. Okay. But absolutely, yeah. We welcome one and all.
Yeah. So. Oh, that's wonderful. And I also want to tell our audience that Elizabeth is a regular, I would say very regular, participant now in our board meetings, which is wonderful. Are you bored? Are you bored with the board?
Not at all.
Yeah. It's a very interesting board, actually. So,
it is.
Yeah. So she's not bored, and she's a great contributor to it. And so they are now attending our board. Now, I know that you guys have talked about. Oh, the other thing that we're hoping that we're going to get a few of you on is going to be our bus trip in the spring. And we would like it, as I said, would lower the age on the bus if they ever did a median age by quite a significant amount. And it would certainly add to the pleasure of everyone else on the bus. So we're not sure where the bus trip is going yet exactly. It will be wonderful and exciting, and I will announce that when we know, and I hope you'll be able to come.
We do as well.
Oh, well, we wish you, I know we all wish you a wonderful time. I can tell by you've had a wonderful time. Yes, you did. I can tell.
Yeah.
And you are going to have a wonderful time. I know it. And there's so much going on there.
Thank you.
Yeah, and it's going to be wonderful. And New Zealand, I can't wait to hear about it.
We're all looking forward to it.
Yeah,
as Norielle and I have been getting through these administrative details. Adrienne has been there like, don't worry, it's so worth it.
Yeah, it is.
As
you
get through all this, you know, craziness with flights and everything, it's like, it's all worth it.
It's wonderful. It's going to be wonderful. It really is. And Global Studies at Penn State Berks must be doing a very good job.
Because sure
look what's
so.
Happened. Yes, I think you do think so, and it's great. And Elizabeth also wanted me to say that her other interest is business. Am I right?
Yes,
so you're kind of combining those things together.
Yes.
I don't know about the rest of you, but said
I'm doing a business minor.
You're doing business minor too.
Yes,
a business minor too. What about you, Norelle? Do you have another?
I want to pick up a history minor. I just love it so much.
History and global studies together. Well, that sounds wonderful. And I just want to thank our guests for being here tonight. They are so nice to come and leave their school and tell us about their exciting time, and we wish them well. And I want you all to know that next month in November, we will be talking about Nepal. We have a person who lives in Reading who knows a lot about Nepal because he's from Nepal. So we should be having a very, very interesting program. So please tune in the third Monday of November, and we will be having a very interesting discussion about that. So to everybody out there, thank you for tuning in, and good night.